Professional wrestling is about to get a much-needed shot in the arm in regards to cultural relevance, because, let's be completely honest, AEW, nobody cares anymore. The new kid on the block had stumbled for the past year and change, and frankly, they're lucky to get over 600,000 people on a Wednesday, 250,000 on a Friday, and I don't know who's turning on the TV on Saturday. And in regards to the Fed, there are still some, hangers-on that think that, oh no, guys, the big deal with Netflix, oh, it's gonna be fantastic, it's gonna be great for the product, so it's gonna be paywalled. And that's gonna make it bigger and better? Yeah, okay. Or how SmackDown went from being on network television, getting 2 million people, to getting kicked back down to the USA Network, not even being able to pull a 1.5 its second week out there. But no, don't worry. The other hot product that they have under their umbrella at NXT, oh, it's gonna be so much better over on CW. A network that has never turned a profit and is on the brink of collapse. No, don't worry. Professional wrestling is hotter than it's ever been. Everybody loves Roman Reigns, and Cody Rhodes is the face of a company. That's why we need to constantly run back people that were relevant 30-odd years ago and tell their stories, because I haven't really made anybody as relevant or even a fraction as relevant in the subsequent 30 years. But hey, don't worry about it. We got the Vince McMahon miniseries, docuseries, whatever Netflix is going to be doing later this week. I do believe it comes out on the 25th. And yeah, it almost gives me enough of a reason to sign up for a Netflix account. But then again, I look at what else they're offering and it's like, no, I'm good. Probably just catch some of the clips, or maybe I'll see it one day with the help of my good friend Captain Jack Sparrow. But like I said, the premiere date for this is, I do believe, yep, the 25th, all six episodes. So they're just going to batch drop all of this. So over 200 hours of interviews have been scoured over, and there was a trailer that was released. And frankly, it looks interesting. It's just, what specifically are you going to focus on? Are you going to focus on Vince's early life, living in the trailer park, not knowing who his father was until his mother let him know that, oh yeah, that guy running Capital Wrestling, yeah, he's actually your dad. Going into, buying the company from his father, promising not to take it nationally, buying up all the competition, making professional wrestling a household entertainment media, really revolutionizing it. This is as soft on the product as I am right now, mostly because I'm seeing the product that there is right now, to try to minimize or rewrite the script on how instrumental Vince is where it is right now, I'd be doing it a grave disservice. So I don't necessarily know what they're going to be doing in this six-part expose. What are they going to be focusing on? Because now we're starting to hear from the people that were involved in it, and frankly, I'm a little skeptical that this is going to get anything close to approaching the truth, or if this is just going to be dramatized, because that's normally what you get from any of these big budget docuseries. I've been around long enough, you likely have as well, where you're just going to get half truth, whole lies, whatever is the most entertaining way to tell this story. Not necessarily worried about whether or not it's the most factual. It's about if it's the most entertaining. And if this was, a different target in the microscope, Vince would definitely be along with, playing up some of the more fantastical elements. But we also know where a lot of this is going to focus on the 94 steroid trial, and of course, the much more recent Janel Grant stuff. But there is so much in between. There's a lot of good source material. Are they going to use it? Probably not, because the character of Mr. McMahon is going to be apparently taken front stage, as opposed to the subject of the docuseries, Vincent Kennedy McMahon. They're just going to be used interchangeably. Let's take a look. Vince McMahon slams Mr. McMahon Netflix docuseries ahead of release. The series is deceptive and uses editing tricks. We've kind of heard this before from a bunch of different things, or wherever somebody's a little bit ex post facto regretful of their involvement in something. If it doesn't come out as well as they hoped it did, they'll just go ahead and lay the blame at, everybody else, saying, oh, it was deceptively edited. Oh no, I wasn't. They didn't use the whole context of the interview. Oh, it was played up for effect. What really happened is this, this, and that, which, to be fair, could end up being a case. Like I said, like we've seen earlier, over 200 hours of interviews. You're talking about a time span of events that takes place apart 5-6 decades if we're going back pre-WWF days. Like I said, there's a lot of good material that's there. It's just, what are they going to focus on, okay? Former WWE CEO and chairman of the board, Vincent Kennedy McMahon, says that he has seen Netflix's upcoming docuseries about his life, and he's not happy with it. In a statement posted to his social media accounts on Monday, the wrestling promoter said that he recently screened an early partial cut, and that based on what he has seen so far, this doc falls short and takes the predictable path of conflating the Mr. McMahon character with my true self, Vince. The title and promos alone make that evident. Well, instead of going with the Hollywood Reporter's recounting of events, let's just go with Vince's first-hand information itself. I don't regret participating in the Netflix documentary. The producers had an opportunity to tell an objective story about my life and the incredible business I built, which were equally filled with excitement, drama, fun, and a fair amount of controversy and life lessons. Unfortunately, based on the early partial cut I've seen, the doc falls short and takes the predictable path of conflating the Mr. McMahon character with my true self, Vince, and the title and promos alone make that evident. A lot has been misrepresented or left out entirely in an effort to leave viewers intentionally confused. The producers used typical editing tricks with out-of-context footage and dated soundbites, etc., to distort the view distort the viewer's perception and support a deceptive narrative. In an attempt to further their misleading account, the producers use a lawsuit based on an affair I ended as evidence that I am, in fact, Mr. McMahon. I hope the viewers will keep an open mind and remember that there are two sides to every story. End of statement. And yeah, you know, I could kind of see that coming, because like I said, I watched the trailer. It's pretty flashy. I'd show you guys, but Netflix is, you know, quite strike happy when it comes to showing, you know, even promotional material for their content. So it's better leave sleeping dogs lie than lay down with them and end up getting fleas, which is ultimately what happened here. Listen, Vince, like, you're winning, okay? Winning bigly in regards to your ongoing lawsuit right now. It's been a minute since I've checked in on that. It's not that I haven't been following along. It's just been a lot of motion practice where third-party doctors involved, but in reality, were the doctors inconsequential? All you need is the records, or realistically the lack thereof, in order to disprove any of Janelle's claims. But we'll get to her in due time. But the people that could already see the writing on the wall when it comes to this docuseries, WWE Hall of Famer expects that there is a lot of BS in a Vince McMahon documentary. Well, yeah, exactly. And this is somebody who, for long stretches of time, didn't necessarily have the most closer personable relationship with Vince. In just a few days, the highly anticipated Vince McMahon Netflix docuseries will be officially released in the streaming platform after first being announced in October of 2020. Due to the events that have taken place over the past 4 years, wrestling fans are very curious as to how the series will portray McMahon and what exactly will be covered. Following the trailer's release, many fans online were concerned about how McMahon would be portrayed given the talking heads featured. In addition to this, some have previously expressed issues over the accuracy due to wrestling being known for having a revisionist history on the teams involved in producing the series. Now, they'll go ahead and try to spin it one way because this is one of the wrestling rags that's out there. But yeah, the people that appeared in the trailer, you had Austin, you had Rock, you had Taker, you know, all of the guys that were making money at the time when the business was actually booming, big stars in the business that people look back upon fondly, instead of the current crop of losers that could be indistinguishable to other fans in the stands. Let's just say if likes of Bam Bam Bigelow or Vader fell over the railing at a Chicago Bears game, they wouldn't be snatched up by the security guards and mistaken for a common audience member. Let's just say that wouldn't happen when the business was actually booming, when Vince was in charge, when Vince was calling the shots. While appearing at a virtual signing for Signed by Superstars, Hall of Famer and current employee at AEW, I think still, maybe potentially? Like, what's happening with Lance Archer? Anyways, Jake Roberts was asked if he would be watching the upcoming series.
Possibly. I'll be watching the Netflix Vince McMahon docuseries. I'm going to wait and find out how much truth's involved first. I was mentioning it would be a lot of BS, which is what I expect.
Well, yeah, exactly. Because The Rock, he's been making the interview rounds recently. Well, not so much so in regards to the Joe Rogan interview. That was about a year ago at this point in time, but he was recently on PBD, and that has been absolutely lambasted as one of the most vacuous interviews he has ever done, because The Rock, as much as he says he has no ambitions for doing anything political, he is as vacuous as Kamala when it comes to answering a question. Like, the guy will not pin himself down on any specific issue. Like, he's as fake as they come. They might have, Netflix, in an attempt to get it in good with him, you know, they might have got something out of him. If they're going to be trying to spin anything that Austin says out of context, that'll be quickly taken apart. And Taker, yeah, I don't think he said anything bad about Vince literally ever. One of the most loyal guys to him. So they might find some fringe guy, might misconstrue something, or somebody who's looking to sign a Legends deal, potentially running back history about how Vince was, oh, he was just so terrible. But in reality, unless you're trying to sue him for something, like with Janel Grant, about what everybody's thinking, you know, at least one of those episodes is going to be entirely dedicated towards, because that played a lot in the trailer. But it's interesting, within minutes of Vince posting this statement on Monday, okay, Janel Grant's lawyer, and she is the ultimate clout demon. She's almost worse than Janel herself. Because the backstory on this is, apparently, nobody asked Janel to be a part of this, which is interesting. I've heard conflicting reports on that, but I've also heard from this attorney, that she hopes that Janel has the opportunity and the ability to tell her side of the story to the public. I was like, bitch, you filed a lawsuit. It's like, isn't that what you're trying to do with that? But it's never about seeking justice, speaking out so other victims could come forward. It was about securing a bag, and this has become so goddamn obvious. But Janel Grant's attorney responds to Vince McMahon's statement on Mr. McMahon docuseries. Ann Callis, the attorney for Janel Grant, has issued a response to Vince McMahon's comments regarding the upcoming docuseries. Based on the early partial cut, Vince McMahon made his statements on this series debuting September 25th, and Mr. McMahon, Laurinaitis, and WWE are being sued by the former employee, who alleges, yes, all of that fun stuff, including getting yesterday's corn caught up in her hair. Grant's lawyer, Ann Callis, released the following statement. Vince McMahon physically and emotionally abused and assaulted and trafficked Janel Grant for more than 2 years. Oh, you're just making those claims right now. Well, Janel is definitely suing for some of those allegations in civil court. Vince hasn't been convicted of any of that stuff in regards to Janel. That's, quite defamatory of a statement you're making there, stupid. You would think a lawyer would know a little bit better than to do something like that. Calling this horrific and criminal behavior an affair is delusional and nothing more than a sad attempt to save his shredded reputation. By the most technical terms, that's kind of what it was. They were banging each other on the side, and Vince very much publicly is married, so technically speaking, isn't Janelle's agreement during their time together is by textbook definition an affair. I don't know what to tell you. Although Ms. Grant has not seen the Mr. McMahon docuseries, we hope it shines a bright light on his abhorrent and criminal actions by accurately portraying the realities of his abusive and exploitative behavior. Ms. Grant will no longer be silenced by McMahon. Yeah, we know. You filed the lawsuit the Royal Rumble weekend. Again, you've been anything but silent over this past year. Like, I don't know what to tell you. Her story, though deeply troubling and very fantastical, almost as if it was ripped from the headlines of a WWE writer's room at one point in time, and exceptionally painful, is a one that can help other survivors and find their voices. We seek to hold McMahon, Laurinaitis, and WWE accountable as long as they have enough commas in their settlement. Oh yes, and give Ms. Grant her day in court.
which she desperately doesn't want and is fighting tooth and nail to pressure Vince to try to settle and to give her one final payment. It's quite interesting, and I guess we're going to end up finding more by the end of the week, because people will be able to comb through the 6 episodes that will be on display for the public. I'll be interested to see what comes out of that, but honestly, reporting on a Netflix docuseries and trying to find some truth out of it would be like turning on Disney Plus and citing Agatha as a credible source to how we need to be nicer to witches, or gay ones in that matter. So with all that said, thank you all very much for the gift of your time. I've been Don Consuelo. I want you to follow your gut and get after it. Take care, everyone.